Today I'm reading from Mark chapter 6, verses 7 through 13. You can follow along in your pew Bible. I believe it's page 38 in the New Testament. That's over halfway through for those of you who might struggle a little bit. Would you hear the word of God proclaimed? Then he went out among the villages teaching. He called the 12 and began to send them out two by two. He gave them
God.
the same mission. God calls all of us into a life of service. We're to share love with others, that's the end. When I have pressing decisions to make, I want others' counsel and input. It's not because I don't think that I'm capable or that I'm incapable of making decisions on my own. I know I'm very capable of that. It's not because I'm afraid I'm going to make a misstep, although I do at times, as we all do. But it's I want the input of others who have different opinions, who can give me insight that maybe I've not experienced. I have to admit to you, folks, I'm ignorant. I don't know a lot about Ohio history. Now, my wife, who's an Ohio native, she schools me all the time. I get this payback for her living in Texas. She schools me all the time, and we spend the day in Youngstown yesterday driving around, and I said, there's a lot that I just don't know about this community. It's fascinating. All will inform me of history and pressing issues that I may be totally unaware of because I don't come from history. Jesus realized the disciples had good days and they had bad days. They were human. They had strengths. They had weaknesses. If you've ever been with friends who have different skills, it's a lot of fun to watch a person who has a very logical, analytical, systematic thought process. Who is kind of an artist and a creative, and you have all these ideas just swirling around, and it just drives this other person nuts. I just love that. Now, I don't want to be in the midst of that, but I like to watch and observe. But good ideas come out of it, just give and take. That's what we need to do, the midst of give and take. Christ's admonition to us is don't be a solo operator in your mission. When God stirs your heart to serve Him, pray for others to share that mission with you. The second thing we need to realize is that since our mission is communal, we don't just make our life about one thing. All we do is to be about kingdom work. You know, the church, we don't possess this singular authority to practice in our own activity. We practice, we do mission as an extension of Jesus Christ. That's where we see the authority. That's where we see the power. You know, Jesus told His disciples to go out and preach the word. He said, heal, anoint them, lead others, guide others, tell them about the gospel of Jesus Christ. Our ministry is not about prestige or about power or influence or about material gain. It's about remembering the basics. You know, we read this text. We continue on this text and we hear Jesus as He sends His disciples out two by two and He tells them, leave all your stuff at home. What stuff can you set aside today? Today's communion Sunday. All will be invited to Christ's holy table. What things are that you might want to set down to leave here at the altar rail before the feet of Jesus Christ that are burdensome? that you share your story every time about your problems in your life, not necessarily. One of the most important things that we learn about serving Jesus Christ is to listen to that other person and find out where they are. Did you share that story? Sometimes you can carry Jesus also told his disciples how to deal with rejection. The reality is, Christians, you're going to encounter rejection in time. Not everybody that Jesus or the disciples spoke to about their faith or their hope of salvation was particularly interested. Ever had that occur? You know, you share your faith with somebody, and they do this. Either physically put their hands up, or they turn away, and say, no, I don't need that stuff. I don't need all that Jesus stuff. I'm doing fine on my own. All people don't desire to hear the gospel message of Jesus Christ, but hear these words from you, God. Just because someone doesn't want to hear the gospel, and you hear that one time, or two times, or three times, or 10 times, or 100 times, doesn't mean that you're off the hook, really, young master. I keep telling people about Jesus, and they just tell me no. There's that one person who wants to hear the gospel message. The situation you find yourself in is one of non-receptivity. Just move on. Jesus said, shake the dust off your feet. That meant, you know, everything that's in this community, I'm leaving even the dust on my feet. I'm leaving everything. There's no program here for you. You won't listen. It's just time to move on. This lighthouse that we worship in, this wonderful, beautiful church that we worship in, is a beacon of hope, is a beacon of God's grace, is a beacon where you can hear God's message proclaimed, and life will be changed. God is not through with Youngstown or Lyme. If you want to talk about negative stuff, go talk to somebody else. Because God has called this church, Trinity United Methodist Church, which has a long historic history, and to continue life in service. And that's hard work. That's what we talk about. If you want to walk on the water, you got to get out of the boat. How many of you have ever won an argument by aggressive arguing about Jesus Christ? Anybody? Jesus didn't do it, and neither should we. If the gospel message you proclaim is rejected by the people that, you know, you've done what you need to do, they're people of free will. They have chosen not to hear that message at that time. Time may come. But remember that lady? Remember that lady talking to you about Jesus Christ? Remember that man who was talking to me when you're on the bus? I was walking away. God has dared to send Trinity United Methodist Church to the heart of this community. Now, I told you I've driven around this community. I've only been here for what, a week, 10 days? And I've just driven around this community a little bit. And I see history, and I see people who are committed to staying in this community. to proclaim and spread the message of hope and redemption in the grace of Jesus Christ. This is a new day. What is the baggage that you need to set down and you lay aside before you come to this communion table or at this altar rail? What are those things that you may hear that Christ would take on for you? You live a life of freedom, a life of obedience, you travel life. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. This morning, we have the